Hello guys, welcome to Code with BK. So in this video, I have solved question 8 of ISC 2018 Computer Science Theory paper. So I've written the solution here, and just because this is a theory paper, so I don't think I had the need to write and test it in front of you. So this is the answer and this works. And I'm going to go through this question and I'm going to go through this solution and tell you what all things you need to keep in mind and what all issues you could have faced or you might face when you're solving a problem similar to this. Okay, so this is the question, give it a reading, and this is the solution. The first few things you need to keep in mind is whenever you are writing a program like this in a theory paper, make sure you always add comments, because it is also given in the question paper that use mnemonic names and comments so that the logic of the program is clear. And adding comments is a good practice whenever you are coding, even in the industrial level. Okay, and the point of mnemonic names is, for example, I've used scanner is equal to something like this. I could have easily used a simple S here, but this scanner in small indicates that it's an object of a scanner class, easier to understand. Similarly, I have used equalmatic P and Q here. I could have used X, Y, A, B, anything, but just because the equality which checks, the method which checks for the equality has two matrices P and Q, so I've used similar names, right? So make sure you keep these things in mind. Second, you make instance variables private and constructor and methods public. So whichever data members you use, instance variables, make them private. Again, it's a practice and it's highly recommended that you make them private. It is not given in the question description, but it is something that you should follow. Similarly, for member functions and constructor, make them always public. It is not given in the description again, but you should follow. Next thing is method names and variable names have to be exactly the same. For example, the to store integer elements is small a, m and n is store the number of rows and columns respectively, and I have kept the name of my variables exactly the same. Similarly, for the methods read array check and print, and even with the parameters which are passed, for example, p and q, I've used p and q, mm and nn for the constructor and mm and nn for the constructor. Okay, so this is the solution I have. So the first thing was the private data members, which is not a difficult part. The second is the constructor, and if you see in the description of the constructor, it says parameterize constructor to initialize the data members m and n. So that is what is set, but it does not say that you have to create a 2D array, and you cannot create the array before you have the values of m and n. So you cannot create an array here. You need to wait for the values of m and n, and then only you can create the array. So if you do not create this, you get a null pointer exception and you lose some marks. Okay, then we have the method read array. Okay, so this is something that I have to change. It is read small a array and read small a array, read small a array. Okay, so what read array does, it reads the values into enter elements into the array. Okay, point to be noted here is there is nothing that is passed into this method. Right, there is no parameter here. So you cannot create a scanner or a buffer reader in the main and you can read values there and pass it to the object here. You need to locally open something like a scanner or a data input stream and you need to read values. That is what I have done. So I have created a scanner, and every time an object is created for this class and the values are supposed to be read into this array, scanner will be created and values will be read. So I'm using scanner because scanner.nextint is an easy option when you want to read values into a matrix, because nextint ignores all white spaces when it is looking for an integer. So I've created a video that explains about nextint. You can check it out. Okay. Next thing is this method check. Okay. So this takes two parameters, which are objects of equalmat p and q, and returns one if they're equal and two they're not equal. Returns one if they are equal, zero otherwise. Okay. So this is the first line where I'm checking for the dimensions. It is given that you can assume that the matrices have the same dimensions. Still, I've added this check, and then I check for the corresponding values. Thing to note here is that I can assess private data members. For example, I've done p.m and q.m, and these are private to this class m, n, and a. Similarly, I have assessed the respective arrays of p and q. So this is possible because this method is inside this class which has these private data members. Had it not been the case, I would have to add some getter to get the values of m and n or a, But since this method is inside this class and these are the private data members for this class, I can assess them directly. This works. Okay, and next is the print. Okay, so next is the print. Okay, and as you can see, like I have taken the help of the description, for example, to enter elements in the array, these things. So you can help take the help of the description to add comments to the program, but please do add comments. Okay, so next is the main. So I have two matrix objects. I have given them the same dimension because it's assumed same dimensions. I'm adding a line to the console that asks for the six integer values. This is hard coded. You can take 2 into 3, something like that. But it's just to demonstrate. So hard code is not an issue. I call read array on P, read array on Q. Similarly, read array on Q. Change a line for clarity. Print matrix A using the print method of P. Print matrix Q using the print method of Q. Okay, and then I'll check for the equality between P and Q. Question, there are two questions here. First thing is, you use P or Q to check. You can use either. Either of it works. And second, pass P within a method for P. For example, P.checkPQ. So you're passing the reference to P after calling the check method, which is inside P. So you might get confused, but this will work. Think it clearly that check method takes two instances, P and Q, and it does not matter if it is inside the P class. It will work just fine. Okay, so let me just compile and check. So Java C, Java. So six values are 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, P and Q are equal. Similarly, I'll do for unequal case 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 8. One value is not equal, so P and Q are not equal. So my program works just fine, and I added the key highlights that you need to take care of when you're writing a program like this. So I hope this video was helpful. So please like my video and subscribe to my channel for more such videos. Thank you for watching.